Welcome to the first issue of our UpLoad video magazine for 2025. It's going to be windy again this time. This is great for the energy transition and more than just a playground for Liebherr cranes, which have to deliver truly peak performances when erecting wind farms. We also show how a clever idea makes working with lattice sections easier and what customer satisfaction and inspiration can achieve. Enjoy! In the geographical center of Germany, in the federal state of Hesse, our cranes are at work at a wind farm, including one of our powerful LRT cranes. In Schenk-Lengsfeld, the powerful all-terrain LRT 1100-2.1 of our Spanish customer Aguado supports a lattice boom mobile crane in the erection of four huge wind turbines. As a versatile helper, the LRT 1100-2.1 assists an LG 1750 in the modernization of old wind turbines. Four turbines with a hub height of 165 meters were erected. The two-axle vehicle was able to provide active support both for setup work on the large crane and also for the pre-assembly of individual components. Especially for the fast relocation of the derrick ballast between the individual lifting operations of the LG 1750, the extremely versatile rough terrain crane can utilize its strengths and quickly move the ballast blocks to their new position for the next lifting operation. A flexible power pack that can move loads of over 20 tons. Even the rainy spring and the adverse ground conditions could not prevent the rough terrain crane with all-wheel drive from doing its job. With its huge tires and pronounced tread, the LRT was even able to cope with ankle-deep mud and moved easily between the systems. The perfect partner for this job. When the job calls for heavy loads and lofty heights, our lattice boom cranes are ideal. A hammer and sheer muscle strength don't really help with securing the lattice sections, however. This task requires hydraulic power, and this normally comes from large hydraulic equipment, at least it used to. Matthias Waidmann from the crane inspection department offers us an alternative approach that makes this work easier and more convenient. Hi, Matze.
Hi, Martin.
So how does the new solution work?
This is the new battery-powered bolt-pulling cylinder. It's entirely battery-powered, and we use it without any hydraulic hoses.
Hard to believe. I have to see that.
Give it a go.
And now?
Let's go inside and take a look.
Okay.
So here we have a lattice bolting point. Now we can use the cylinder. I would always lower it into the guide from behind and then attach the whole thing at the front. Okay, then there's this on button here. We press it. And then the hydraulic pump starts. Then, using these two buttons, we can move the cylinder.
That's really easy. How did you come up with this idea?
Well, the idea is actually borrowed from fire brigade technology. They've been using these battery-powered cylinders for some time to widen the passenger compartment to vehicles involved in accidents in rough terrain.
And did it work right away?
In principle, yes. Our plan for a different area of application is that we also want to apply a tensile force. In other words, we want to get the bolts out again using greater force. Then there's this remote control too. So, if we've got bolts under tension here, then there's an acoustic signal as well, and we can leave the hazard area and then move these bolts using this remote control.
What advantages does a battery-powered bolt puller like this offer you in practice?
Well, I see one very clear advantage. We operate it using a battery, so there's no need for a combustion engine. The same goes for the hydraulic hoses, which can be hooked in anywhere. And so too with the handling. We're able to manage these four bolting points very easily now. We lift it up. It weighs 16 kilograms. And I think those are major advantages.
Great, thank you, Matze. The best ideas come from practical experience. And now it's getting a bit windy again. In our next article, we're celebrating a special anniversary. In 2004, our customer Nolte ordered its first LG 1750. 20 years later, the successor model to this legend, the LG 1800-1.0, rolled off the production line. And once again, Nolte welcomed the first one into its fleet. The new crane has now been in operation for over 6 months. The LG 1800-1.0's first deployment was on the replacement of a wind turbine. And of course, we were there to watch. Just near Flensburg, or to be more precise, in a wind farm in Wanderup, the LG 1800-1.0 was tasked with removing an entire rotor from a wind turbine and replacing a faulty rotor shaft. This was a tricky undertaking because at 147 tons, the Star was no lightweight. But it was no problem for the 800-tonner, which was able to demonstrate all of its power on the job.
In this configuration, we have an approximate maximum lifting height of 144 meters. We took the rotor off at 27.5 meters and put it down at 31 meters. This was no big problem thanks to the vario ballast.
In favorable wind conditions, experienced crane driver Rainer Schlesner was able to carry out the lift without any problems and remove the rotor. The powerful LG 1800-1.0 passed its baptism of fire at Nolte with flying colors. And the crane driver is delighted too after its successful first outing. Switching to the new crane was easy for the experienced Schlesner, especially since the control system on the new Liebherr cranes, large and small, is the same.
Nolte had a total of five LG 1750s, which were replaced sporadically. Nolte has built well over 1,000 wind turbines and, of course, also completed various industrial orders, with the LGs proving themselves time and again in these applications.
It really is impressive to see how customer satisfaction is expressed and what inspiration our cranes can provide. And on the subject of inspiration, in April 2025, the world's largest construction machinery exhibition, Bauma, is being held once again in Munich. Many of our customers and fans will be heading to Munich to experience our equipment up close. Our design director, Dr. Ulrich Hamme, will also be there. Hi, Dr. Hamme.
Hi.
Could you perhaps give us a quick taste of what to expect at the forthcoming Bauma?
Sure, I'd love to. Right now we're in the hectic final period just in the run-up to Bauma. All of the preparations are running at full speed. The plans have long since been completed. We need to be finished because the whole thing starts on the 7th of April. The date is set in stone, so there's always a last-minute frenzy just before Bauma, that's for sure. But we're getting closer to the goal and the anticipation and excitement are rising.
What equipment from Ehingen can we look forward to seeing?
We actually always make use of Bauma to showcase our broad portfolio of products at the trade show with example cranes. In the rough terrain crane sector, we're unveiling a new 130-ton model, and in the telescopic crawler crane sector, a new 150-ton model. Many of the cranes at our stand are LTM cranes. LTM is really important, and that's true this time in particular because of Nikon 3. In the Nikon 3 area, we'll be showcasing three new types of crane that feature the new look and design. But of course, we'll also be presenting some new products at the trade show. One of them will be our 400-ton crane, a powerhouse on six axles. It was on display last June in Ehingen for visitors to marvel at on our customer days. So of course, we'll be giving this crane a suitable outing at the trade show. And for the small LTM cranes, we'll be rounding off our product portfolio with the 100-ton and 110-ton models. We'll be showcasing our biggest exhibit at Bauma 2, a lattice boom crane, the LG 1800-1.0.
The machines you've mentioned are almost a given. So are there going to be any surprises, perhaps?
Yes, there'll be surprises too. We've got something new up our sleeve, our ace card. We'll be showcasing an MK120 at our stand. Why an MK crane at the Liebherrwerk Ehingen stand? Because we're once again responsible for marketing and servicing this type of product. And with the alternative drives too, we have something new to offer. And we've done our homework, always inspired by the concept of reducing exhaust and CO2 emissions. Alongside our tried and tested LTC 1050-3.1E, which can optionally be operated in a hybrid manner from the top cab and crane mode with a diesel engine, HVO or electricity from a socket, we'll be presenting another new type of hybrid electric crane that will once again take this technology to a new level of innovation.
So a lot of exciting stuff ahead. Dr. Hamme, thank you very much.
My pleasure.
And that's all for now. I'm already looking forward to the next issue, when we'll be reporting directly from Bauma in Munich. See you soon.